The sounds of Turkish helicopters and bombs rattled the Assyrian community of Beersheve in northern Iraq. On June 20th, Turkey carried out a strategic attack against positions by the Kurdistan Workers' Party, a designated terrorist organization by Turkey, the United States, and the European Union. But oftentimes during these attacks, marginalized communities like the Assyrians are left without consideration and little to no protection. Hundreds of Assyrian towns still exist in Iraq. These close-knit communities house around 150,000 Assyrians. That's a small size compared to just a few decades ago, when over a million Assyrians considered Iraq home. In the midst of fighting during the Iraq War, persecution by ISIS, and now pressure from Kurds and Turks to leave their homeland, Assyrians are fleeing the country in large numbers for safety. Despite this pressure, thousands still remain. Those that stay say they refuse to leave the ground their families have considered home for over 2,000 years.
It's not today's incident or event. This is happening since decades. Even during Saddam's time, there was a deal between Turkey and Iraq that Turkish army or Turkish airstrike can come forward in Iraq to attack the PKK since 90s.
Athar Kado is a teacher from the largely Assyrian village of Al-Kush near Beersheve. When he learned about the bombings, Athar said he immediately contacted his friends in the town and learned that a helicopter had flown near the community and began bombing. I spoke remotely with Athar to learn more about the incident. Athar, thanks for speaking with me today. Can you start by telling me more about what happened on June 20th?
I was in Al-Kush, and then I started contacting our friends. They clarified how it happened and what happened. It was a helicopter who attacked, and it was one in that specific area. But normally, regularly, they are bombing in mountains. Sometimes they are so near the village, sometimes they just hear the explosions.
What is the town of Beersheve like?
Beersheve is like considered as a safe place for those villages who are northern of Beersheve, like for example in Çelik, in Şaranış, and so on. If there is an attack there, they flee to Beersheve, one of the places, and to Zahu and to Duhok. This time it was near Beersheve itself, and it horrified people that were in the town. And at the same time, the Turkish government, they are saying, we will bomb PKK wherever they are, whenever we want.
Why are the PKK near these Assyrian communities?
Lately, like when these operations are starting, the PKK are coming to our villages, like that are inhabited by only Assyrians. They are asking for food and so on, and they are staying near the village. So that's causing that the airstrikes, and the Turkish army is bombing these positions or the cars or whatever that have PKK members. By these explosions, sometimes it's affecting directly to our village. Like last year, there was some village that had been emptied. So when a military group is coming to the area, and they are like with weapons or and so on, if they come to the area and tell them that we want to stay around the village, they can't really say no. Even if they would say no, which some did that, they were like being attacked by these groups. Maybe there is some individuals are trying, but majority of people, it's like they don't want that to happen to them. And they are really threatened from both sides.
It sounds like Turkish bombings and PKK members are not the only threats that these Assyrian communities have faced. Can you talk about the challenges these people have faced in the past decade?
Many of these villages that are being affected by today's situation between PKK and Turkey, many of them had been destroyed many times by Saddam's regime, by Saddam government, because there was KDP people there. They used to come as almost the same thing that's happening now, that the PKK are coming to our village. It was the fight between the Kurdish political parties against Saddam, and they were covering themselves in this village, so many villages had been destroyed. For example, from Al-Kush to Sheikhan, it's a near district, we have many villages that are emptied 100%. we have families came from such village and came to Alpoş, and now they are like Alpoşians, and they didn't return to these areas. And that started from 70s until 91, and then in 91 there was more fight and so on and so on. So specifically these areas had been affected in that period of time. And again, those villages in the borders are still facing the same situation almost.
So Atharat, just to clarify, you're saying that dozens of Assyrian communities in northern Iraq have either been emptied or completely destroyed by attacks like the one in June.
Yeah.
So what is the situation like for these communities now?
They are really tired of such situation, and it's becoming being in a horrified situation as a daily life. Especially, as I said, the villages that are really near the borders, they are like, we don't know when they will bomb. We don't know where, if it is in our house, if it's near us, if it's in our agricultural areas that we live from our daily life and we get income from them. So it's like we are really tired, and many people already left these areas because of such situation.
If safety is a big concern, why don't these people just leave these towns?
Actually, many left, the majority left, unfortunately. But simply, we want to stay in our land. Like, we can't stay anywhere else but in our areas that me and my grandfather and my great-great-great-great-great-grandfather was here. All this area, all this geographic area that contains Iraq, part of Turkey, part of Iran, part of Syria, was Assyrian land. Today, completely emptied by Assyrians, and we are barely surviving, which we want to survive. We want to survive in our land. We want to stay in our land. If the situation continues as it is, maybe not by leaving, but in other ways, we won't survive for more decades.